So Red Nation, I bet you're wondering if these are the same bones or if these are different bones. So there's a lot about them that look the same, but there's some things that look different, like their length and the head shape looks a little bit different about these bones. So are they the same bones or are they different bones? Today at How Radiology Works, we're gonna be learning about foreshortening and elongation, which are both due to the geometry of X-ray imaging and which change the appearance of bones in your X-ray images. So we're going to start off with the ideal case wherein the anatomy or the bony anatomy that you're trying to acquire, the primary anatomy you're trying to acquire, you would like to have the primary ray, what we call the iso ray, be perpendicular to that bone. And you would also like to have your image receptor be perpendicular to that primary ray. So in that scenario, you can see that you're going to have X-rays which will cover this whole bone, and your X-ray image will look something like this, wherein there is not any specific difference between the two sides or the two heads of the bone. It's all being treated roughly equivalently, and this is the best scenario that you would like to achieve when you're acquiring the X-ray images. If you can regularly achieve this kind of imaging, I'm sure you're gonna get extra coffee and donuts. You're gonna get lots of high fives in the hallway, because this is the optimal type of X-ray imaging that you'd like to achieve. Then we wanna talk about a couple different scenarios that we wanna try and avoid, wherein now you can see that your primary ray is now no longer perpendicular to the direction of that bone. You can see now the bone is at an angle with respect to that primary ray. So because that bone is at an angle, when we acquire the image, we now can see that the image is gonna be actually shorter of the bone because of the geometry. If you follow those two outer lines that are gonna outline the edges of the bone, you can see it's gonna be shorter. And you can also see that the magnification is gonna be different for different parts of the bone. So for this head, you can see that because it's closer, it's gonna have additional magnification. So this is gonna be actually larger on this image than on the correct positioning that we showed you earlier. If you're regularly achieving this type of imaging, you're gonna get kind of the thumbs down from your radiologist, because there's variability now. As the radiologist is trying to read the study, they have to determine what's due to the positioning and what's due to the actual anatomical differences. Similar situation will occur if you just switch the geometry. If you rotate the other way, you're also going to have foreshortening in that case. And you can see that your radiologist also is not going to be happy in that case. Now you're going to have this head of the bone being magnified preferentially compared to this head, and you will also have foreshortening in that scenario as well. To put these side by side, you can now see here's what we're calling the correct or ideal positioning. And then with that same bone, the two foreshortened cases, where you can see when they're put side by side, these all are the exact same bone, but you can see the differences in both the appearance, especially of the head, and then also of the length of the bone because of that projection geometry. If we're rotated, we're going to have foreshortening. Preferentially, the different regions are going to have different magnifications depending on which is closer to the X-ray and which is further away from the X-ray. The other topic of interest is called elongation, which happens less frequently in X-ray imaging, but can happen as well. And in this case, the image receptor, so the film or the CR or the DR, is at an angle now with respect to the primary beam. So if the primary beam is coming down right here, the iso ray is coming down right here, and your image receptor is now at an angle, then the projection now is going to be elongated. So the bone is now actually going to appear longer on your X-ray image than the standard correct positioning. This is seen most often, I feel like, in actually dental X-rays, because in that scenario, a lot of times the image receptor you're going to be placing within the patient's mouth. And when that's at an angle, you can see significant elongation. So on the top, you can look at a standard dental X-ray, which is taken with relatively perpendicular image receptor. And then on the bottom, you can see an elongated case. You really appreciate the stretching of the dental anatomy here due to that angle that the image receptor was placed at in this scenario. So in computed tomography, do you have these issues? Here's a bone which is acquired at two different positions. A similar scenario on X-ray imaging is gonna cause those issues of foreshortening and of elongation. But in CT, we have no foreshortening and no elongation because we have many measurements. We don't just have the one measurement, and we add all those measurements up to make our 3D attenuation map. CT overcomes these weaknesses of projection geometry, wherein you now no longer have the same sensitivity in the image to the positioning. In addition to solving the problem of the overlapping anatomy in your projections, also solves the problem of changing magnification in your projection. As you'll notice, we talked a lot about magnification because it really affects foreshortening and elongation. If you haven't seen our video about magnification, check that one out next.